But so now that we've at least attempted to admire Mr. Modi and everything that he stands for, let's come to the other really corroded, termite-ridden institution in our country today, which is the media. And you're so much a part of it, Rajdeep. There was a time when I was, and now I'm not. But help us understand what's gone wrong with the media and why is it failing so deeply in its duty?
You know, this is the most difficult question to answer, because if I point one finger at the media, they can easily point four fingers at me. I'm very much part of this sort of this particular media age in which we live in. I just think that the media has lost. I think firstly, the business model of the media has collapsed. You cannot have a country with 424/7 news channels, because then eventually the size of the cake is such that it's not expanding, and each of us are trying desperately week after week through TRPs to capture whatever little is there through the advertising pie. And as a result, what happens? Either people are entering the media for the wrong reasons. They are politicians, they are land, you know, they are builders, each of whom want use the media for purposes other than journalism. And those within are so dependent on government patronage. I was in Kolkata last week. 85% of the advertising for the Bengali news channels is from the government of Bengal. Can anyone then challenge Mamata Banerjee? Let's be honest, the Modi model is not just in Delhi, it's across India. Chota Modis are coming up everywhere. Kejriwal also. At the end of the day, Kejriwal is very clear. He's going to give you his large Delhi government advertisement only if you support him. You see, the ability to be adversarial to the establishment is becoming more and more difficult because the business model is flailing. And when the business model flails, how do you then continue to take on the government in power? Who are the two biggest advertisers on TV today? Government of India and Ramdev. So you will rarely get a story against Patanjali. I mean, I would love to have a hard, big investigation done into Mr. Ram, the amount of land that the land bank that Ramdev is creating across this country. But how many people are willing to actually take on a Ramdev today or question a Ramdev? How many people are, and along with that, I think what has happened, particularly in newsrooms, and a lot of the problem is partly TV, and a lot of it has to do with sort of this North Indian Delhi capital that we are in, where I think Hindutva has become such a dominant force in society that it spread to the newsrooms as well. The new normal, the manner in which we've normalized the Hindu-Muslim, the Hindu-Muslim encounter in a way, where an OVC represents sort of the Muslim view, and we'll get someone equally sharp from the other side to represent the Hindu view, and they're in constant conflict with each other. And newsrooms seem to celebrate that. You know, I would have thought in the past we would keep out the likes of, you know, any of these sort of the shriller voices particularly, out of live television debates. Now we want people who will give polarized views. We don't like moderate views. You know, we don't like people who talk shades of gray, because TV may black or white. You know, everything is black or white in our society now. We have created a cockfight debating culture. Again, because the business model has failed, it is so much easier to have 10 people around a studio shouting at each other rather than going and finding out from a detention center in Assam, how are those 3,000 people living who have been declared illegal citizens? It's so much easier. So we have taken the easy way out, and we are TRP driven, particularly television. And mainstream Hindi news media has also completely compromised to the government in power. And Modi is cleverer. He has realized our weakness. He is, and we are complicit. Let's not blame Mr. Modi. He has only, let's blame ourselves. We have failed the profession. I became a journalist because I thought I could make a difference. Today I look around myself and ask myself, why the hell did I do this? I'm in a snake pit, because the snake is a reptile with no backbone. And the truth is, the media has no backbone. No, we are not willing to call out the lies of government, the lies of those in power, whether it's in Delhi or in any state government.
You know, when we were talking about the new phenomenon, this gigantic phenomenon we live in, it's perhaps the only era in the history of journalism where more journalism is done on exposing the opposition than the government, you know? I mean, what is the function of a media that goes after opposition more than the establishment. It's a complete inversion of the very function of journalism, which is to speak truth to power.
No, I'll give you an instance which I give in the book, Shoma, that on the day when the NSSO report came, which I think showed unemployment levels, was it unemployment or
45-year low.
At a 45-year low. Suddenly at 4:30 in the evening, there is an item on several Hindi channels in particular, sources, ordinance to be brought in for a Ram Mandir. Immediately from 6 o'clock, the debate has shifted to Ram Mandir. Hindi news channels have not debated in particular unemployment, agrarian distress, jobs. I mean, unemployment, agrarian. I ask why? They say, nahi sir, bikta nahi hai. So, jo bikta hai, wo dikta hai. Bikta kya hai? Dharm. Bikta kya hai? India, Pakistan. So, you get a retired general and you get a retired general from Pakistan, retired general from India shouting at each other. You see, generals, once they leave the army, are very happy to bomb each other's country. So the two of them will say, let's bomb Pakistan. They say, bomb India. And we create a sort of narrative which is completely divorced from reality. I was reading this fine piece today by a columnist, Shankar Iyer, which showed 1,40,000 MSMEs are stressed. A majority of the toilets in Anganwadis don't have toilets in this country. More than most government schools today are 30% short of teachers. Now, these are the issues on which there should be at some stage. It's not about Modi. It's about governance. You know, problem is everything. If I say this, people say you're anti-Modi. It's not about Modi. Modi will come and go. The governance crisis in India is getting more serious. And we don't want to really address that fundamental crisis. And I think we in the media just feel that these governance issues don't sell. So tomorrow we might as well do pornography, because pornography is going to sell. I mean, what, you know, if everything is going to be jo bikta hai wo, jo bikta hai wo dikta hai, or vice versa, then we might as well think of something else to do.
But you know, Rajdeep,
open a chai ki dukaan.